2 Samuel chapter number 5 from verse 7. There can be no greatness without breaking through strongholds. And strongholds are found at the gate of destiny. Somebody say strongholds. One man who became great in the Bible, his name was David. And before David came on the scene, the enemy had control of this territory. Somebody say territory. You must understand that in our journey and in our walk with God, we are called, anointed to take over territories. Somebody say take over territories. I know you are only interested in breakthroughs, but God wants you to actually take over territories. I know you are interested in a new job, but God actually wants you to take over. I need to stretch your mind, child of God. Your mind must be stretched, child of God. I said your mind must be stretched, child of God. You are supposed to be bigger than what you are right now. You are supposed to be better than what you are right now. You are supposed to be wealthier than what you are right now. You know, this morning I woke up and woke up, hardly slept. And, you know, as I was spending time with the Holy Spirit, it dawned on me that the resources being enjoyed by unbelievers are actually ours. Somebody is in my rolls. Somebody is living in my penthouse. He said, the silver is mine. The gold is mine. The fact that it was stolen does not mean it's not mine. Reg, the Bible says the thief comes, John 10 verse 10, to steal, kill and destroy. Hello? But there's good news. Jesus, you come after the thief comes. COVID came, but Jesus is coming. Poverty came, but Jesus is coming. Problems, they came, but Jesus is coming. I know you are in debt, but Jesus is coming. I know there are issues, but Jesus is coming. I know marriage is frustrating right now, but Jesus is coming. I know your business is upside down, but Jesus is coming. There is a coming of Jesus. I'm not talking about the second coming. I'm talking about a divine visitation. I said there is a shift. Jesus, he has given us these things that pertain to life and godliness. We have been given already. Our job is to possess. I said these things, they belong to us. Deuteronomy 29:29. The secret things belong to our God, but the things that are revealed belong to us and our children. So the Lord revealed unto me that actually these things are ours. Once upon a time in the land of Rhodesia, it dawned upon a group of people that no, something is wrong. Why is the colonialist controlling our land? It dawned on them, and they decided to do something about it. I don't know about you, but there is a spiritual chimrenga. There is an era I have seen under the sun that proceeds from the ruler. Folly is set in great dignity. Unbelievers are enjoying our wealth. They are enjoying our influence. They are enjoying our properties. They are enjoying our economy. I don't know about you, but I'm ready for the fight. Uncompromising, I'm ready for the fight. And I know that they that are with us are better and stronger than they that are with them. You need some holy tenacity if you're going to take over. You have to first refuse to be refused. Deny to be denied. Hallelujah. You have to make up in your mind first that this thing is an error. I should not be living in one room. It's an error. I should not be living on the wrong side of Second Street. It is an error. I should not be driving a teenager car. It is an error. I should not be having anything less than $1 million in my safe. It is an error. If I truly am a child of God and silver and gold belong to him, where is the problem? There is an error. Shadabahaya. I refuse to accept small breakthroughs. I refuse to eat just crumbs from the master's table when I can sit on the table. I refuse to stay outside the gate when I'm supposed to be on the inside of the gate. I refuse to be locked out of the economy. Jehovah God, you have raised an army at KPM and they are ready to go into the enemy's camp and take back the things that were stolen by Lucifer and his children. We are getting ready this first quarter. We are introducing a military dimension. It just dawned on me. He said I've seen servants, unbelievers on horses, driving X7s, unbelievers, pimps driving Rolls Royces, drinking champagne, while God's children are trying to fit into a Honda Fit. He calls it an error. And errors must be corrected. It's a season of corrections. Your address needs to be corrected. Your transport arrangements need to be corrected. We are going to correct it. I said we are going to correct it. Jehovah God, whatever we need to do to correct it, be it fasting, we'll fast. Be it praying, we'll pray until further notice. Be it sacrifice, I'll put it all on the altar. Whatever I need to do to correct the error. Second Samuel chapter number 5 from verse number 7. The Bible says, nevertheless, David took the stronghold of Zion. That is the city of David. After he took over the stronghold, he gave it his name. I saw us buying buildings prophetically in town. Shalida Bahaya, Trust Towers change to KPM Towers. I saw us buying buildings and changing their names. After you buy a building, you can give it your own name. You can name it after your grandmother's dog if you like. He called it the city of David, a man after God's own heart. I'm not here to encourage you. I'm here to tell you prophetically what must come to pass. I did not lose my sleep for nothing. There are things that the Holy Ghost, he began to download on the inside of me after he took my sleep from me. And I'm here to download those things. He said, eye has not seen, ear has not heard, neither has he entered the hearts of men, the things that God has prepared for KPM. I said, there are buildings prepared for us. I said, there are contracts prepared for us. There are new realms. There are mountains to climb. There are rivers to cross. There are buildings to buy. There's land to buy. There are malls to build. There is a 20,000 auditorium to be built. There are hospitals to be built. There are first class orphanages to be built to the glory of God. This ministry will build schools and hand them over to the government. How else can they listen to us when we are not doing anything to support what they are doing? This ministry will build prisons and hand them over to the state and say, state, let's get into a partnership, the divine and the governmental. How then will we not get the ear of the president when we begin to do things on that kind of dimension? That dimension is thy kingdom come. Thy kingdom come is not tongues. Thy kingdom come is not rolling on the ground in church. Thy kingdom come is when we begin to do things, things that are proper. Nevertheless, David took. There are things we need to take. He took the stronghold. The stronghold is what the enemy calls his. The territory that the enemy says that this territory is under my auspices. It's under my rulership and my control. The city gates we need to take over. Where the enemy says, this is my stronghold, this is my strong area. We need an anointing to go into the mining sector, Bart Simpson, and begin to take over. I said, we need to go and take over. What the enemy says, this is mine. We are saying we are taking over. We have coexisted with the enemy for too long. We've played second, third, fourth fiddle to the enemy for too long. I need a holy anger to come up on the inside of somebody. And you make up your mind that, no, I'm better than this. No, things should not be like this. No, I cannot sit in one little corner somewhere. The devil is a liar, and so is his mother-in-law. We are here to take over that which the Lord has promised us. Surely, surely, this cannot be the end of your life. Verily, verily, this cannot be the level that God ordained for you. Where are the banks in the kingdom of God? Where are the hospitals in the kingdom of God? Where are the malls in the kingdom of God? We need the grace. Nevertheless, despite the problems, nevertheless, despite COVID, nevertheless, despite the Zimbabwean economy that is not only upside down, it does not even exist. Nevertheless, Shadi Bahaya, Mazide Bahaya, Loko de Bako Zatile Reboko de Bahaya. He took over the stronghold. That is the city of David. Give me the next verse. Now David said on that day, whoever climbs up the wall, the way of the wall of the water shaft, defeats the Jebusites. These are the people who were controlling. The Jebusites were controlling. But listen to how they are described. These are the lame and the blind. The economy is being run by the lame and the blind. They are blind to the gospel. They are lame concerning the things of God. Shadabakata, but they are in control. Sadibo shilereba kodebe kedida hayanda mahaya. The Bible says this thing called power belongs to God. And if this thing called power belongs to God, and I am a child of God, it means I should have power. The Bible says silver and gold is mine, says the Lord. If silver and gold belong to my Father, then I should have the silver and I should have the gold, because he is my Father. And he said in Psalm 82 verse 5 to 7, do you not know that ye are gods? I mean, all of you, not just pastors, children of the Most High. You are a God, but you're living like a pauper. The devil is a liar. It's a serious error under this sun. It's an oxymoron. It needs to be changed, shifted. Hallelujah. It must be changed. I know you're here for your breakthrough, but that's just crumbs. So I don't want crumbs. I want my portion. There is your portion in this Zimbabwe. I said there's your portion in Mozambique. There's even your portion in Rwanda. I said there is your portion. The Bible says in Proverbs 25:25, good news from far. Good news. news from far. Hanabahaya, who told you you don't have your portion in the States? Who told you you don't have your portion in Canada? If the white men can come and colonize Zimbabwe and take their portion from Zimbabwe, I can go into the United Kingdom and take my portion from there. Your penthouse in Dubai, now we are talking. Your house in Cape Town, beachfront properties, now we are talking. And you name it after a biblical character, and you lift up the name of the Lord, raising a banner for Christ. That's when we are taking over. Not when we're just praying in tongues in church, rolling on the ground and vomiting in buckets. The devil is a liar. There needs to be a shift in this kingdom. Enough of accepting what is. No, we want to change what is. I want to talk to barrier breakers. I want to talk to movers and shakers. I know you're not yet there, but I know that you know that God prophetically spoke to you, and you know it's time to break free. It's time to shift. It's time to take over. Enough of seeing things in your dreams. Enough of seeing things in your visions. I don't want to drive a car in my dreams. I want to drive it here and now on Second Seed Extension. My Father, my God, grant me the grace to break out of this mold. Grant me the grace to take over my territory. Grant me the grace to take over the CBD. KPM must be the epicenter church in this CBD. And we begin to broadcast from the epicenter right near the Reserve Bank, strategically legislating things from the realm of the Spirit, declaring and decreeing things into the economy. Enough of just praying for a stand. We need estates, not stands. Where is my good news from far? You are coming out of these restrictions. You are coming out of these frustrations. You are coming out of these strongholds. You are coming out of this bondage. You are coming out. I don't know about you, but I'm coming out. For by my God, I'm in Psalm 18, verse 29. By my God, I can run through a troop. By my God, I can leap over a wall. Every troop at the gate, I will run through you. Every wall, every high wall, I will leap over that wall. In other words, I'm breaking out and I'm breaking through. Zandamaya, Zatobaya, Latobaya, Yetebeketibaya. Father, grant me the grace to fight. Grant me the grace to fight. To fight for my destiny. I want to be delivered at the gate of destiny. I want to break free at the gate of destiny. Jehovah, Jehovah, Ladibagadabaya, Ezababadola Labahaya, O Kababadola Bahaya, Zetebeketibaya. Today is your day. Today is your day. Atabaka talabahaya. Idedebe keri andulamahaya. Andabazato bahaya. Need to shift to warfare mode where you tell the enemy, enough is enough. This is not my level and I'm not settling for this. Andamaka tamahaya. I'm bigger than this. I'm better than this. Break out of witchcraft. Break out of it. Break out of limitations. Break out of family limitations. Break away from the hold of the enemy. Yadabaka talabahaya. Ando bakuta bazato labahaya etebeke telerere bugozidahaya andara bakadarara rabahaya azebeke tebeke tibahaya o labababakata lamahaya. My breakthroughs that have been held by the enemy at the gate, I command and I demand. In fact, I insist on a release in the name of Jesus and by the power of the Holy Ghost. I insist. Anda makuta mahaya adebeke zetebeke dimahaya. I'm not going to wait for breakthroughs. I'm going to take it from the day of John the Baptist until now. A kingdom suffers violence, and the violent, they take it by force. Today, we are taking some things by force. Everything that has been delayed in your life, you are taking it by force. Masata bahaya andola bagota basata labahaya edebeke zetebeke dibahaya hato bagota basata labahaya edebeke zetabahaya hazababa bakata labahaya. I said you're supposed to be a high flyer. Edebeke zetalabahaya. You are a limit breaker. Open your mouth. Refuse to be restricted. Refuse to be denied. I'm taking my company by force. I'm taking my real estate by force. I'm taking my trucks by force. In the realm of the spirit, I have to possess it in the spirit first before I get it in the natural. The problem is you've been waiting when you're supposed to be fighting. You've done 40 quotations, no replies. The devil is a liar. Last minute disappointment. The devil is a liar. You gotta fight at the gate. I said you gotta fight at the gate. For a great and effectual door has opened unto me, but there are many adversaries. I will tarry in Jerusalem until Pentecost. I will tarry at the gate until the gate opens. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors, you ancient doors. Open up that the king and his children might come in. Open your mouth. Open your mouth, child of God. Open your mouth and pray. David took the stronghold. He didn't wait for the stronghold to be broken. It's not broken over time. You have to be the one to break it. Where is your payment? You got to break through. You got to break through the stronghold. You have to break through it. You don't break through strongholds with good English. You break through by aggressive prayer. Pray the prayer of importunity, the kind of prayer where you don't give in, the kind of prayer where you don't stop. The anointing is coming now. Come on, pray. Lift up a standard. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will raise a standard. 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 If you are tired of your level, raise a standard. If you are frustrated, raise a standard. Remember the same power that raised Jesus from the dead. It resides on the inside of you. Refuse your level and say, I will not die at the gate. I will not get stuck at the gate. I don't want to be like that man who was stuck at the gate called Beautiful. The gate was beautiful, but his situation was ugly. Jehovah God, I'm here to fight for what's mine. I'm here to insist on my breakthroughs. I'm here to insist on my new level. I'm here to insist. I'm here to insist. I refuse to be locked out of the $1 million contract. I refuse to be locked out of the multi-million dollar deals. I refuse to be locked out of construction deals. I refuse to be locked out of the energy industry. I refuse to be locked out. I refuse to be locked out of agriculture. I refuse to be locked out. That devil is a liar. I said, I refuse to be locked out. I said, I refuse to be locked out. Give me verse 10, 2 Samuel 5. And David went on. And he became great. You say you don't believe. You are too hung up on your problems. Stop worshiping your problems. When a prophetic word goes out like that, you grab a hold of it. And David went on. And he became great. I know things are tough right now, Marlon, but you will go on. You will go on. I know the devil is frustrated, but you will go on. Don't give up. You will go on. You will go on. Shadabakata. I said, you will go on, Isaac. You are not staying there. You are going on. You are going on. You are and David went on. Just because this is where I am right now doesn't mean that this is where I'll end. I will go on. I will go on. I know the enemy has you tied up. But you will go on, Melissa. You might be stuck somewhere in Mavuko with a small church, Joshua, but you will go on. You will go on. You will go on. You will go. I know you think to enter Uchikoro Mahara Tanatsuka, but you will go on. You will go on. You will go on. You might be restricted and frustrated right now. Ferreira, you will go on. You will become great. You must go on. You must go on. And I speak to everything that threatens your greatness, that is at the door of your breakthrough. I speak to that thing, and I know it hears me. For God has put coals of fire in my mouth. You must go on. You must go on. Mkwenya, you are under witchcraft, but you will go on. You will go on. Bring him here. You will go on. You'll go on. You will go on. Shadiba sadiba shalida daba. Look at me, Mkwenya. You will go on. So daba shalida bakata bahaya. I said, despite the resistance, you will go on. You will become great. There are things that fight your greatness. Kalapa duba shalida daba. Kadide shele. Sode jalide deboko dida daba. Kolaba katila ramahaya. Lazando jezi kili deba. Padukase jalida daba kodaba. Lazarus, come forth. I open that grave today. And I command you to come out. Shalida bago daba kadiba haya. You shall come forth. And the Bible says, and he that was dead came back to life. You see, the problem is you're just looking at him breathing. No, the business that was dead came back to life. The marriage that was dead came back to life. The church that had died came back to life. Sunday, that's how you read the Bible. You personalize it to your situation. Don't just see Lazarus in the grave. See your dead situation coming back to life. I refuse to serve God stuck at the gate. Your amen is tired. Your amen is tired. I refuse to serve God stuck at the gate. Shaliba katabaha. You have gone around this gate too many times. Urungo tendera urpa gate. Kadi gazota mashabahaya. Bakala debakatabahaya. Yadabagadabahaya. 38 years at the pool of Bethesda. Laka, which was by the gates. Those five porches were by the gates. So diba jali debeke diba haya. There was a colt that was tied up at the corner of Bethany and Bethphage. There was a gate there. There are people who are tied at the gates. So there is an anointing this morning. If you are here, there is a grace. I'm not here for good English and eloquence. Today I'm not here with excellency of speech, but I'm here with power. The same power that raised Jesus from the dead will raise you up. It doesn't matter how long it has been. If you hold the hem of the garment today, why the hem? Because the anointing flows from the top down. The anointing is heaviest. The oil is heaviest at the hem. It all ends up at the hem. That woman was strategic. She knew. She just had to touch the hem. Right now, in the name of Jesus. Stretch your hand towards me, prophetically touching the hem of the garment, and I prophesy, whatever long outstanding situation, it could be 10 years, 12 years, 38 years that you've been stuck at the gate, I command and I demand your freedom at the gate. There's power everywhere, power everywhere, power everywhere. People are being delivered everywhere. Ushers, please wake up. Yeah, help them, help them, help them, help them, help them. Isaiah 49:25. Shall the captives of the mighty be delivered? Shall the captives of the Almighty be delivered? The captives of the mighty be delivered. Anyone under the sound of my voice who is caged by witchcraft, be thou unloosed. Be thou unloosed. You could be online. Receive this word. Be thou unloosed. Woman, thou unloosed. Man, thou unloosed. Boy, thou unloosed. Girl, thou art loosed.